come from teaching, the teaching ministry per se. Before I used to teach, but since 3 years ago, I was assigned to the parish. Ito pala yung buhay namin, para pago ko. But I thank God for this experience because now, what I'm going to share with you, many will really come from my own experience as parish priest. And like to just share with you those beautiful experiences as parish priest and catechist. So we'll start with the pastoral letter of the CPCP. Just like to read the paragraph. So the title of this conference is this CDCP Pastoral Exhortation for the Tribute of Mercy and Renewed Catechesis in the Spirit of Discipline and Evangelization. The talk will not really be on the mercy. I guess Bishop Banyan yesterday gave us a beautiful reflection on mercy and connected with the healing. I would rather, I choose to look at this pastoral letter in the context of renewing our catechesis, precisely because this is also the year, 25th year of BCP2. And BCP2 had a beautiful chapter or section on renewing catechesis. At the same time, we are still continuing the path of evangelization. And if you notice, there is no post-synodal apostolic exhortation on the synodal new evangelization of 2012. Instead, we have the post-synodal apostolic exhortation of this last two synods which came out last Friday. And then that's the reason why Regina Huleco, because I was waiting for that to share with you that here. Bakit wala yung post-synodal apostolic exhortation and evangelization? Because Benedict resigned. And supposedly the Pope is supposed to write the apostolic exhortation. Pope Francis had a chance to write it, but he did not write it as a post-synodal exhortation, but his first apostolic exhortation is Evangelical Gaudium. But if you look at the footnotes of Evangelical Gaudium, many of the propositions on the synod of evangelization, he used them. So practically, but he owned it because he was not present in the, during the synod of evangelization. Unlike John Paul II, remember Catechesi Tridente. Catechesi Tridente is the apostolic, synodal apostolic exhortation of the synod of catechesis for children and young people. And it was called by Pope Paul VI, but then he died at the end of the synod. So susulat na lang, he passed away. Then John Paul I came, then after 1 month, he passed away. So John Paul II came, and that was his one of apostolic exhortation, Catechesi Tridente, and he had the right to write it because he was in the synod. So he knew the proceedings of an Catechesis. That's why we can say that Catechesis is really the fruit of that synod. Instead, Evangelical Gaudium, while Pope Francis borrowed many propositions from the synod, he owed it as he called as his own. And then for me personally, if you want to see what the evangelization is in person, you find Pope Francis. At ito, kitang-kita, lalo na dito sa Amoris Laetitia, The Joy of Love, talagang makita niyo talaga yung his vision on how the church should evangelize today. Particularly in the context of marriage and family. Okay? So, the pastoral letter started with a question: in this forthcoming year of renewed dedication to mercy, the Eucharist, and the family, under the light of PCP2, how shall we as church respond? And I would like to rephrase the question in the context of the catechetical ministry. So we could read the question like this: in this year of renewal dedicated to mercy, in the year of the Eucharist and the family, on the 20th year of PCP2, how shall we, ministers and catechesis, respond as we take the path toward the new evangelization? And of course, we don't digress from the document, we still look at the document for its answer. And in the middle of it, we read that if we want renewal, let us kneel again. And kneel again in repentance, in adoration, and in the service of the family. So, because of this, these three directions of kneeling that the pastoral letter suggests to us, I read this in the context of the Minister of Catechesis, in particular, in terms of content and methodology in the present time. Okay. That's why, for this conference, I would like to discuss three topics. First, before the Father's merciful gaze, let us kneel and approach the sacrament.